Good evening. Welcome to this, I guess, final of concert of the Music at Late St. Luke season. Of course, the next July 14th, as always, we will have our Bastille Day concert, so hope to welcome many folks back for that. Welcome to those here, and also the folks watching either live or later on YouTube. Don't really have much else to say, but I do want to introduce our recitalist for the day, Michael Plagerman, who's going to say a few words about the Mulet, and then he asks that we just hear the whole piece as one before applause at the end. So, Michael?
Thank you all for coming. I'm really thrilled to be playing this piece, especially on this organ. Having a little actual French color is a really welcome thing for this music, which is performed very infrequently. The fact that it's perhaps Mulet's most performed piece is telling. He composed relatively little. He was born in 1878, and by 1911 he had basically given up composing. It became impossible for him to get his works performed, and he relegated himself to church improvisation. But in the years prior to that, he had written this piece during a time of intense meditation and time when he essentially lived in the church. His friends began to refer to him as the mystic. And I think you hear some of the sort of big spatial architectural sounds of large French basilicas in this piece. It is dedicated to the memory, to the glory of the Basilica of the Sacred Heart on Montmartre in Paris, where he grew up. His father was the choir master there, and his mother played the org harmonium, and he began subbing for her at a relatively young age. The only thing I'll say about the piece, because I think the titles of each movement are pretty evocative, is that it's divided really tidily into two halves. He doesn't say this, but the first half, movements 1 through 5, are actually about the building. They're the nave, stained glass, the rose windows, the bell tower. And then the second 5 movements are actually about things that happen in the church. They're about the procession, Noël, they're about funeral chants. Interestingly, there are three sort of funerary themes here. There's the chapel of the dead, there's the funeral chant, and there's the in Paradisum, which when we get there paints a sort of bleak picture of funeral rites. And then, of course, closing with something that has not a particular liturgical significance, but maybe a broader theological one, tu es petra, thou art rock, referring, of course, to the chair of St. Peter as Pope. Anyway, enjoy the Byzantine sketches.
And if you'll forgive me for one more reminder on the program about the Rachel Loran concert in October. And I did want to say thank you to Anna Stepler for assistance at the console.